Well, when I first heard about Godzilla being made, my first reaction was, oh, I've seen some remakes before, I don't know. But then when I read who was a part of the film, all the actors that were already attached to the movie, and then I read the script, I got really excited because I knew that like this one was going to be different and special, and you know that they wanted to do it justice. I had an opportunity to see the director's first film. It was a movie called Monsters. And I couldn't believe that he made that kind of movie under, what, $1 million or something like that? The graphics were crazy. And, you know, it's funny because I watch both films, Monsters and Godzilla, and I see a lot of Gareth Edwards' style and similarities. I'm assuming you know, too. And it's funny because he's just such a geek about these things, and he just about monsters. And it was great to work with him because you felt that on set while I was working on Godzilla. You felt his enthusiasm about, like, we're going to make an epic, great movie. What's great about Godzilla is that it has explosions, it has destruction, it has all the action stuff that people are going to want to see. But like you said, you know, it has the human element that people will also relate to, you know, because that's universal. You know, if something destructive was going to happen in the world, people come together, and that's what happens in Godzilla. And there's definitely that story with Aaron Taylor Johnson's character and Elizabeth Olsen's character, where are they ever going to see each other? They're in two different parts of the world, but they want to meet up to make sure, you know, that they make it through this catastrophe together. So I think people are going to relate to not only just watching and being entertained by Godzilla, but also the human element. Aaron Taylor Johnson, the lead in Godzilla, you know, I feel his talent and his just bravado, I think, is something that you don't really see at his age, you know. And I think that you're right, he is a leading man. And once people see him in Godzilla, they'll see that he is a leading man. But also, you know, when you see him, not only does he do a great job being a leading man and carrying a film, but you know, like, then you watch past films of his and you see that he does really great character work, and you don't really recognize him in all his past. Every character he does is different. And I think that speaks volume of somebody who's serious, who has the looks, who has the chops. And you know, I think Aaron Taylor Johnson is absolutely the real deal. Mm-hmm. And it was great to work with him. He was absolutely funny, by the way. He keeps it light on set, which is, you know, in this kind of circumstance, you know, when you're sort of fighting a fictitious beast or character or monster, however you want to call it, sometimes you got to keep the mood light, you know, in between takes. And Aaron does a great job just keeping, you know, the vibe on the set, like, light and just, you know, everybody just enthusiastic, too. Troy, you know, I want to destroy Detroit. You want to know why?
Why?
Because Detroit has so many abandoned stuff going on, abandoned buildings, abandoned everything. I want to tear it down, save the city the cost of tearing it down, let them just clean it up, and just build it up to the big metropolis that it once was. That's what I would do.